Alright, so we're going to be playing Know Your Enemy by Green Day, and we're going to be playing a very, very basic, bare-bones version. There's not going to be any of the fancy stuff. It's a lot of the versions of piano parts of songs that you hear are too hard, and this version is just the minimum that you can learn that sounds like the song. So this song is in the key of B, so your notes are B, C sharp, D sharp, E, F sharp, G sharp, A sharp, and B. So there are three chords in this song. There is the B major chord, there is the E major chord, and there is the F sharp major chord. The notes in the B major chord are B, D sharp, and F sharp, which you can play on the piano by putting your pinky on the B, your middle finger on the D sharp, and your index finger on the F sharp. So there's your B major chord. Now you can transition easily to the E major chord by moving this middle finger from the D sharp to the E, and moving your index finger from the F sharp to the G sharp. And there is your E major chord. The last chord that we use in this song is the F sharp major chord, which you can play by putting your middle finger on the F sharp, and your thumb on the A sharp, and your pinky on the C sharp. So there's your F sharp chord. The introduction to this song uses your B and E chords first. So it goes. And the F sharp chord is only used once in here, and it's right after that, so I'm going to play the thing pretty slowly. After the intro, the melody comes in, which is very simple to play. I'm going to play it with one finger pretty slowly for clarity. So. It starts on the D sharp and uses the E, so. C sharp, B, C sharp, D sharp, B, C sharp. Alright, so now we have to add the bass chords to our melody. And we can do that very simply. We can do it two ways. The first one is just by playing B chords with our melody. That looks like this. And the second way is by switching between E and B chords. And you always switch to an F sharp chord at the end. I forgot that. And there you have your first part. Now that repeats 10 or so times. And then you have to switch to another part in the song. So what you do is you move this hand up here. And how the melody of that goes is. And the bass for that is pretty simple also. You can play the B and then E and then B and then E and then F sharp chords. So together that looks like. The second part to the second part in the song is very similar to the one we just did, but it's a bit different. I'm going to play the melody slowly. It goes like this. The bass to that section is very simple, and like the one we just did, it goes B, E, B, F sharp.
When you put them together very slowly, it goes like this. Again. And now, on the track, it repeats the one that we just did. But if you want to make it a bit more interesting, you can come down here and do a little bit of a alternation on that, and it looks like this. I'm just going to go through it fast because it's not really on the track. And then after that, you just go back to doing your first one. And that's basically the song, except for one other very short section in there, which is different. So, there's only one more part to this song, and it's the last part. And I'll play the verse that we just learned, and then I'll, as I go into the ending, I'll slow down. You got the idea there. So the first thing it does is I kind of play the vocals there. So when I come out of the last verse of the one that we did before, you go. And you can just play those B chords there. That's fine, because it kind of quiets down on the actual track. And then I just went into kind of how it started. And from there, it just goes back to the chorus, and that ends. And that's your song. Thank you. Alright, this is the finished product. We're going to run the thing all the way through, and we have a drummer to accompany us. And it'll sound a lot better with him.